Hello, my friends. Welcome to another Empyrean Test Drive Edition. In this small video, I'm going to show you off a capital vessel, Class 3, which is Nomad XT. It's a Jay Reynolds design, and it's he says that it's a starter vessel, but if you watch closely, and we are going to see that a little bit later in the video, the resources that you need to make this ship, it's a little bit steep for a starter vessel, but it's fully armored. It's the big brother of Nomad ST, which is it has the same design, but it's not an armored capital vessel. In this case, all of this ship, it's armored on the outside, so it can withstand some blows. And of course, since it's armored, it needs much more engines and more thrusters so that it can compensate for the heavier weight that it has. So if you want to know a little bit more about this Nomad XT, it's a great capital ship. Join me in the next few minutes so that you can see a little bit more in detail what are the specs of this nice capital vessel. So, watching at this capital vessel, let's see the specs from the outside to the inside. Believe it or not, it's a level 10 blueprint. You can have it, you can spawn it as long as you have the resources right at level 10, which is awesome. It's something that the author of this this ship, Jay Randall, always does, which is lower the specs needed to spawn the blueprint, and you can add what you want. And for instance, if you place here advanced turrets, it will need restium, and it will increase the spec level. By leaving just the spots to place the turrets, you can place them as long as you progress in your game, and with it you you get this blueprint available earlier. So it has a very nice and big landing pad on the top, and a very, and we are going to see that in just a moment, and in a nice hangar. It just has one hangar, but it's a big one, and you can store lots of stuff. It's well protected, fully armored, and that's the reason why you see that many thrusters. So entering the capital vessel from the top, you have a central elevator. You can in this central elevator, you can get anywhere on the ship. Level 2, top hangar, probably for your small vessel, and you might have a very big, and it can, I think, it has space for more than one small vessel, which is really nice. So level 2, level 1, you have 70 farm plots, as you can see, and direct access to the bridge where you will pilot this capital vessel. You have also some switches to turn on exterior lights and to save a little bit of fuel. If you want, you have a switch for the thrusters and the RCSs. You have here a clone chamber and an armor, and over here some cargo boxes and an O2 station. This is level 1, and you can see, and it has a very nice view with these lovely windows to the main hangar bay, which probably is going to be the place where you'll spend most of your time in this ship. So central elevator again, very easy to navigate in this ship. As you can see, huge open space. You have 4 advanced constructors, 1, 2, 3, 4. Very good storage zone, regular containers, fridges, food processors, armor. You have in both sides, you have ammo boxes, which of course they need to be redundant, if one of them get destroyed, you will have also more ammo boxes where you can have extra ammo for your turrets. And if you go through over here, you will have your personal quarters. You have here a bathroom, a bed, and a shower. So, and the ways in and out of the ship, you have here a nice way down in the which it's in the front of your ship, and you can also leave through the main hangar door in the back of the ship, as you can see. Very nice open space. You can walk quickly to wherever you want to go, because it's a very easy way to walk around in this capital vessel. So, for the resources for building this capital vessel, you need a lot of satium, more than 11,000 satium, more than 7,000 iron, no, around 7,000 iron. No, medium, I think it's a fair amount, 4,500 cobalt, 2,600, and but the main problem building this ship at the beginning, it's going to be the satium. But I think you can manage it by scrapping and some POIs. You might get a lot of satium, might not be enough, but I think it's really worth it. This Nomad XT clearly is a very, very nice capital vessel, and it since it's armored, it's something that you need not to worry while traveling to far planets. If you happen to be a little bit distracted against doing some mining or doing some random task, at least she's fully armored and it can withstand some blows against, for instance, the patrol vessels in other worlds. So I think it's clearly a good investment in getting the Nomad XT. So this is the resources. As you can see, the rare ones are just a bare minimum. I think they are needed for the advanced RCSs, nothing else. And of course, you can customize your capital vessel to your liking. 70 growing plots, and I think you won't need any more a base for yourself. This ship will fill you up because it has everything that you need. So that you can finish your playthrough without needing anything else. Well, at least compared with capital vessels. I hope you have enjoyed this review of Nomad XT, size 3 capital vessel. I will leave a direct link to the workshop in the description. You can check it out. See the full details and additional screens of this very nice capital vessel. Leave me a note in the comments if you are using it, if you are satisfied. I have been using it in my gameplay, and I'm pretty much satisfied with it. It has all the room that I need, and not that I use it for big engagements, but I know that if I need to use it as a combat vessel, it will behave very, very well. I hope you enjoyed this test drive. I hope you found it useful. Sometimes the workshop with the pictures are not enough to make a decision. I hope this video would help you guys decide if it's a good ship for you or not. And let me know in the comments what are your thoughts about this Nomad XT, and even what kind of capital vessels do you use in your playthroughs. I hope to see you guys soon. Take care.